نقدر حمد انزيل اوف سيدنا عقبه رضي الله تعالى عنه. Conquering city after city, he reaches the shores of the Atlantic. Elevating the kalima, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. And when he gets to the shores of the Atlantic, my young friend, look at the vision. These were men on a mission. He gets to the shores of the Atlantic. He gets off his horse. He holds the rein and walks inside the water. And he continues going. And now when he gets to a stage that he can go no further, this is the point where he raises his hands and offers his weakness to his creator and says, Allahumma ashhad inni kad balaghtu al-majhud walawla hadha al-bahr lamadhaytu fi al-bilad. Oh Allah, I want you to bear witness that I have done everything in my power to convey the message La ilaha illallah. Had it not been for this ocean, then I would have continued going till only you alone and alone are worshipped in the land, are worshipped within the universe. Amr ibn al-Jamu', he was lame, he could barely walk. His family was stopping him from participating in Uhud. Yet my brothers, such was the zeal, when the call was made for Uhud, he became deaf to the cries of his own children and participated in Uhud and fought with the kuffar till he was martyred and met with his creator. The battle of Qadisiyah, a Persian challenges the believers, okay, who will come and fight me, man yubaris? Alba ibn Jahash al-Ajri from the believers responds. He responds to the challenge, and in doing so, his stomach has been cut. His intestines come out of his stomach and fall to the ground, and he collapses. And you know, whilst he lied there, he was trying to get his intestines and put them back inside his stomach, and he was unable to do so. A believer passes by, he asks his Muslim brother, I beg you, help me with my intestines. And he does so. This Muslim brother takes the intestines, places them back in his stomach. In this condition, Alba ibn Jahsh places his hands on his stomach like this, and he makes the effort to stand. He stands, and then he charges towards the Persians. 10-15 yards, it is too much for him. He collapses, and he breathes his last, and he meets his creator. They excelled in this so much, that you know, Uqaydir was the king of Dawmatul Jundal. And he testified to this. This was the testimony of a non-believing king. He would say with regards to the great Khalid bin Walid, he would say, no people see the face of Khalid, small in number or large in number, except that they are defeated. You know, when the Muslims fought with the superpower, the Persians, and they would overcome them in every battle, in spite of the fact that these people many a time were barefoot, they were carrying sticks, and the Persians were in their hundreds and thousands. The Persians began to believe that these people are not human beings, and they began to say, Diwan Ahmad, Diwan Ahmad, that you are not fighting human beings, you are fighting people from another planet, you are fighting jinnat. You know, the Romans, when their children would cry during the night, or cry in general, they would scare them. And you know what they would say? And remember, this was the superpower of the time. They would say to their children, and they would scare them, be quiet, or Abdullah al-Battal will come and take you away. Abdullah al-Battal, one of the great Muslim warriors. And you know, when their horses wouldn't drink water, they would say to the horses, have you seen Ibn Fathun inside the water? Is that why you're not drinking water? Again, another Muslim warrior. You tell me, my young friend, what did Tadmir, a Roman governor, you know, when they met with the forces of Tariq bin Ziyad in Spain, what do you think Tadmir wrote to his superiors? This is what he wrote to his superiors. He wrote, Nazala bi'ardina qawmun la nadri amin as-samai hum amin al-ard. There are people have descended upon our land. We do not know whether these people are from this world or whether they have come from another world. When it came to displaying courage, there was no such thing as an inferiority complex. Displaying courage, and who can forget the battle of Yarmouk? 36,000 Muslims, and on the other hand you have 200,000 Romans. Khalid bin Walid meets the great Bahan, the Roman general. And Bahan says to Khalid, O Khalid, we know it is poverty that has driven you people from your homes. We know there is nothing in Arabia other than desert and, you know, date palms. And as a result you are hungry and poor. This is why you have come. We don't want to kill you. Go home. We will give each soldier 10 dinars. We will give him food, and we will give him clothing, and we will give him drink. And we promise you, we will do exactly the same the following year. You tell me, my friends, when the odds were such, to every one Muslim soldier, there were 7 Romans. What was the response of Khalid bin Walid? The response of Khalid bin Walid was, O Bahan, let me tell you, It is not food and drink that has driven us from our homes. We are a people that drink blood. And we have been informed there is no blood sweeter than that of the Romans. And this is why we have come to drink your blood. My friends, I assure you, it only takes one man to make the difference. Only one man. You don't need hundreds and thousands. Throughout our history, look at Salahuddin Al-Ayyubi. He was one man. You know, when the Islamic State had split into many states, and then many states into many states, and each was fighting his neighbor for power. One man. He was the one that united the hearts of the believers, and he liberated Jerusalem and Muslim lands from the hands of the Crusades. Sheikh Izzuddin Abdus Salam was one man. Imam Bukhari was one man. Abu Hanifa was one man. Sheikh Jamaluddin. So my friends, it only takes that one individual. And I believe it is so possible that one individual sits here before me. If the same fire was to burn inside your heart, then I believe it is so possible that you may be that one individual that elevates the kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah.